Hey everyone, couple of things to show you. First of all, I want to see if I can get that scene with Forrest on the balcony. I believe you're supposed to go investigate part of the mansion and then come back without having acquired the chemical for Barry to give you the acid. Yes!
Jill! Don't scare me.
That's what I was going to say. Aren't you supposed to be going over the first floor, Barry?
Yeah, you're right. But just take a look at this. It's Forrest. Oh my God. I'm going to find out what caused Forrest's death. It looks like he was killed by a crow or something.
That's amazing.
Can you look around the first floor, Jill?
Okay.
Hey, Jill. This must have been Forrest's. You don't have a weapon. Take this with you.
Oh, I have a weapon, all right. Did you see that?
I can't believe.
Okay, Barry. Yeah, I have a couple of things to show you. You might have seen it in my inventory already. Well, I have, actually two things. The first, I will test out across the hallway. And then I'll show you just what my special key is good for. How does that sound? Infinite ammo for my rocket launcher. I'm kind of hoping for a camera angle to change. Let's do this. Well, that looked pretty nice. Let me get my little friend over here from the other side. While waiting for him, I'll push this statue. Yeah, looks like he's coming right up. He is gone. Look at that. Barely anything left. The rocket launcher is a good weapon. Here it is. Remember this? Wow, they actually put an enemy here. Okay. Really? Wow. All right, fine. Oh, the hell with it. I don't even care. I do love, though, how you just smash the head and just send it bouncing. Anyway. Oh, wow. There's actually a reason to come back here. Cool. Oh, wait. Oh my god, I just had a realization. I feel like such a fool. Not that I ever needed the ink ribbon, but once again, I'm using improper perspective. I played the GameCube remake first, and that's where the costume room was in remake. I'll be back. Alright, I've finally done it. I can't believe it didn't occur to me earlier, but remember that room where it just says you don't have the key for it and didn't specify? That must be the special key. Closet A. Well, well, well. Let's take a look. Old clothes. Old clothes. Old clothes. Ah, one outfit that fits us perfectly. Sure, I'll change the outfit. Just a moment, please. Then we just walk right out. Ladies and gentlemen, our cool new look. I'll try to get a bit of a better view. It's kind of hard when it's all pixely and zoomed out. Oh, this will do nicely. Yeah, kind of, sort of. What do you think? There you go. Alternate costume. And that is what we get. Oh, that's even better. And that is what we get with the special key. Hey everyone, it's about time we got a mediocre ending. This time I saved Barry, but I did not collect a single MO disc. I'm going to leave Chris to die. Oh jeez, forgot about these. Wow. Jeez, okay. Well, that kind of hurt. Anyway, because Barry's alive, the place is going to blow up. So we're at least going to get that satisfaction. But our buddy is not going to make it out with us. At this point, all I need to do is really just peace out. And I only need room for one inventory item, which is the flares. So I think I should be okay against the final tyrant fight, right? And there you have it. That's the last enemy in the game that's not the final boss. What do you think? So we're gonna make our way. It's a little weird without Chris. On the other hand, the final dungeon is like maybe 10 minutes worth of gameplay if you're not bothering with MO discs. And the other 10 minutes is nothing but the cutscene leading up to the tyrant. It's crazy. Yeah, the radio again. Moving on. It's times like these I wish I had let Richard die. I just wouldn't have the radio interfere with gameplay. However, whether or not you save Richard has nothing to do with the game's ending. It's, I think, more of a personal satisfaction kind of thing.
There is 3 minutes.
Slight conversation difference. So instead of Chris and Barry going back to deal with whatever, it's just Barry. Chris is going to die. Oh, you just feel that pressure, you know? The timer's counting down while you're on the elevator and cannot move at all. It's pretty sly on the game's part. It just really adds to that feeling of tension. I love it. Okay. Flare time. I will get a single shot off on the Tyrant, then I'll change my ammo. With three healing items, two of them being full heals, I should be okay. I have to position myself carefully. This guy's a sprinter. I guess I'll go with acid first. This is particularly useful against living things. I don't think I'm even gonna run through the acid before I kill him. And once again, I can't skip this. So effectively, one third of my time is preparing for the fight. I only have 2 minutes to deal with the Tyrant. As you can see, a little less than that. God, that is terrifying. That claw is sick. God damn. Wow. I think the scariest part is that he doesn't even flinch, like, at all when you shoot him. Oh, just realized. Yep, there we go. My god. That... Alright. My god. Alright, rocket launcher time, jeez. Shut up. Yeah, let's just go ahead and heal once. Yeah, I thought so. Can I? Oh, I'm pop up. Jeez. Wow! Alright. God damn! This guy's brutal. Let's do this. That was too much. I can't believe I actually had to use all my healing items. And I hadn't saved since before going underground with the hex crank, so that would have been a terrible death. So let's take a look at the mediocre, well, the good minus ending, I guess, because the mansion at least blows up. And Chris is dead.
Your wife?
Yeah. My wife and kids, they always wait up for me. Even today, my oldest daughter. I'm sorry.
Don't worry about that. I know you must still be alive.
Well, that was by far the most interesting ending, as there was actually dialogue. Okay, so Barry's got the picture of his wife and kids, and we'll see what happens to them, because Wesker's alive, but hey, I'm optimistic. Oh, I guess you get the cutscene ending in the credits, just if you blow up the mansion. Alright, now I know. Let's go ahead and skip this as we've seen it. Oh, okay, I guess you get the picture of your character, just even if you don't get the best ending, as long as you blow up the mansion. Also, that total time is due to my playing through most of the game with the rocket launcher. And only two saves, what do you think of that action? So there's only one ending left at this point, the worst one, so that's what we'll be seeing next. Hey everyone, here I am going for the worst ending with my infinite launcher. Fighting Tyrant in the lab, which I have unequipped apparently. I've unequipped my rocket launcher, but now it's re-equipped. There we go. Now it's time to get out of here. Lab key, and now that Wesker is dead, I can take as long as I want because there is going to be no self-destructing of the lab, and there should be no... And there should be no second tyrant either. I played the last two games with Barry, and he unlocked the door for me, so I had to remember that I have to unlock the door, considering that Barry's topside and Wesker is dead. Well, time to get out of here with no self-destruct. So, that's cool. The last enemies I see in this game are gonna be normal zombies. Anticlimactic, I know, but we've been there already. Grab ourselves a battery. Use ourselves a battery. No roaring in the hallway, just go in the elevator. Barry and Chris do not need to hold the fort down while we go, so just cut straight to it. Got the flare, and now with the approach to the helipad and the use of the flare, we complete the game. Now let's sit back and relax and watch as the disappointing shame of what we have done and have not done weighs down upon us. Here it comes. I guess Jill has long hair on the cutscene. And the end. Disappointing. And once again, we failed to stop the tyrant. Look at that time. That's what you get when you don't bother with anybody and use a rocket launcher. Good for me. And yeah, I unlocked the rocket launcher. Hooray. Yeah, generally disappointing ending, but that's what you get for playing poorly. Well, we covered the rest of what the main game has to offer. I've shown you all of the endings, at least as far as the Jill playthrough has gone, and I've also shown you other little scenes that we missed during our first playthrough. That covers the regular game, but there's still one more thing to show you. The arranged mode. I'm going to try to show a compilation of different angles, different enemy placement, different item placement, things that make arranged mode what it is. I hope you'll find it entertaining, and that will conclude our Resident Evil playthrough. prepare yourself for a considerably more difficult and even more moody experience. Until next time, everyone.